Hello, Michael Kerr here, Humor at Work, with a question for you today. What is killing the creativity in your workplace? What is killing the ideas in your workplace? Now, of course, we often talk about the language that kills ideas. You know, that seagull, crap all over each other kind of language. Like, we tried that in 1947 and it didn't work. And we don't have the money, we don't have the time. So, yes, for sure, we have to be aware of the power of words and the power of our language. But beyond just the language, how are you killing creativity in your workplace? Are you killing creativity through perhaps a committee? Because very often, hey, that's how we kill ideas. Let's form a committee and then we'll talk about it for the next 17 years. Now, I'm not saying all committees are bad, but we all know too often that happens. Or perhaps it's too much red tape, too much bureaucracy. Are you too process-oriented and so nothing ever gets done? Are you killing language through your ideas through your body language, you know? Rolling eyes, laughing at the wrong time, folding arms. Are you killing ideas because you're not implementing them fast enough so that people lose their excitement because they don't see any change happening? They don't see any momentum. They don't think they can have any impact or control over the work environment. So, challenge to take back to your team. What are you doing to kill creativity in your workplace? And then maybe, well, that probably requires a follow-up question. What are you going to do to stop killing creativity and ideas in your workplace?